a wholesome consciousness 17, accompanied by wisdom, right? Just their realities. These four, only when when they are present in the supramundane consciousness, they are termed Etipada. Etipada, accomplishment. When we develop our mind, this our desire, our effort, our thought, our wisdom reach to supramundane consciousness, highest level, and then we term Etipada. So when we practice meditation here, as the Bodhipeccha Sangha, right, factor of enlightenment, for Sthipatthana, we experience about that, right? Or the body, the feeling, or the thought, or the Dharma object, mind object, and also Samabhadana here, we try so hard, you know, to gain enlightenment. We experience about that. Or Etipada also here, we have desire, we have effort, thought of wisdom about, as I mentioned before, should be the strong, you know, the decision to develop this Etipada. If you still attached to, if I practice meditation so hard, maybe I might, you know, or something will happen to my body, maybe I will die, something like that. If you're still concerned about that, you cannot get enlightenment. Whatever happens, even, you know, have to die, that's fine. I will not quit, I will not stop. I try the best I can until I succeed my goal. Now we go to Indriya. Indriya. Faculties. Right? Faculties. How many virya, or how many Indriya we studied before? 22. Yeah, 22. This 22 Indriya is for the mind and for the mental state, you know, for the mind and mental state here. For just taking the five spiritual faculties are taken here. Why is it only five? Because they are the factor of enlightenment. Maybe all of you already know that, right? Number one is satindriya, confidence of faith. Number two, viriyindriya, effort or energy. Three is the stindriya, mindfulness or awareness. Four, samadindriya, concentration. Number five, pinindriya, wisdom. So we must have these five faculties strong, powerful, or sharpened and balanced to gain enlightenment. About satindriya, confidence. What is the realities here? Sada. Sada jitasika, right? Sada jitasika. This sada jitasika, sada in Mahakusala. A Mahakriya, a and Apana Javana 26. Altogether 42. So Sata Jidasika in 42 type of consciousness. Normally when we study chapter 2, we are Sata is associated with how many consciousness? Beautiful consciousness, 59, right? 59, but here just taking only 42. Because there is that factor of enlightenment. So for virya here, virya interior effort, virya jitasi, God in 42 type of consciousness, same with Sada. It's 42. For Stindriya, mindfulness here, state, here really is a state, only one, right, state. To stay in 42 type of consciousness, same thing, Sada and Virya. For Samadindriya, concentration, reality here, Ekakata, Chidasika. Ekakata Chidasika, how many consciousness taken especially? 89, but here, just taking 42 type of consciousness, because it's the factors of enlightenment. You're not regarding about akusala, unwholesome consciousness. And panindriya, wisdom. Wisdom, amoha here, just taking only wisdom in 34 types of consciousness. What are 34? It's the kusala, sense fear, wholesome consciousness, accompanied with wisdom, only four, right? Jnana samyak four. So kusala, mahakusala four. And mahakirya, jnana samyutta four. And abhana javana 26. Altogether, 34. Abhana javana is mean sublime wholesome consciousness 9. Sublime functional consciousness 9 plus 9, 18, right? And supramundane consciousness 8, that's 26, we call abhana javana. And normally, wisdom is can associate with 47, right? But here, just taking only 34. Please remember that this satta, virya, sati, samadhi, panya is not normal satta, virya, sati, samadhi, panya. This satta should be firm and strong satta. Firm and strong confidence. It's not blind faith, right? This confidence satta should be based on right understanding. Right, should be based on right understanding. To be able to gain enlightenment, you should have firm satta, strong satta. This satta should be based on right understanding. And virya here should be strong and strenuous effort. Right, strong effort, strong energy. And stindriya state here should be sustained or uninterrupted mindfulness. Such keep, you know, keep, be aware. Every moment, just stay, mindfulness. Just sustain uninterrupted state, mindfulness is required here. As samadhi, the inner concentration should be deep concentration. That should be deep concentration. Our wisdom here is penetrative wisdom. Penetrative wisdom. Wherever you go to Christ meditation, whatever meditation center, you know, all the teachers, they were talking about this indriya faculties, because it's very important for meditator. If the indriya is not balanced, you know, one indriya is the excess, you cannot gain enlightenment. That's why the Buddha taught us, you know, to get enlightenment. Your satta here, confidence, must be balanced with your wisdom. Your satta wisdom should be good together. So if excessive confidence with deficient wisdom is lead to blind fight. So you just have misata, or you have confidence, you know, you have good confidence, but lack of panya, wisdom, has become blind fight, unreasonable belief. So here, excessive faith or confidence with deficient wisdom leads to blind faith. So you have to keep balance, right? Balance your confidence and wisdom. The blind faith is the unreasonable belief. Have wisdom, or wisdom and the satta, confidence should be balanced, right? So if you have excessive wisdom with deficient confidence, it's lead to no concentration. When you practice meditation, no concentration. As you have wisdom, you know, you just investigate everything, thinking about this, thinking about that, something like that. And then, no concentration. That's why excessive wisdom with deficient confidence lead to no concentration. And for a worldly affair, no, who have good wisdom, has no faith, no confidence, is led to dishonest, or cunningness. So, it's worldly affair, right? If someone, they have good wisdom, they know everything, but they don't have confidence, they don't have faith, so that person can become dishonest or cunningness. We cannot trust. And for a meditator, this man who have excessive wisdom and with a deficient confidence lead to no concentration. Even no concentration, which we think, you start thinking about this, thinking about that, something like that, you know. That's why we should balance your satta and panya. And samadhi and viriya, number two viriya. Viriya and samadhi should be balanced. Viriya and samadhi. Viriya here is mean energy, right? Energy, effort. So, great effort with weak concentration lead to restlessness. So we try so hard. When you try so hard, maybe you're not asleep. You're just walking, meditation, so much, something like that. And then your virya, your effort, your energy here so strong, but your concentration so weak, and lead to restlessness, distress, distraction. So should be balanced your virya and samadhi. If you have this strong samadhi, strong concentration, very deep concentration with a deficient energy. It leads to sluggishness, drowsiness. Some deprived meditation, they don't walk. Deprived walking meditation, just sit. Meditation for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, maybe the whole day long. Lack of energy, right? Just strong concentration. And then you feel sleepy, drowsiness, sluggishness. Remember that, right? Sadda and Panya. Panya and Sadda should be balanced, right? Virya and Samadhi should be balanced. How about Sati? How about Sati? Strong state is always necessary. Strong mindfulness, right? Strong mindfulness is always necessary. No excelling of sati, mindfulness. Sati ishta need not be balanced by any factors, right? So much, so strong, so good mindfulness. Just we have five faculties, right? Among five faculties, sati, strong state is always necessary. See that, right? This is very important for meditator to remember that, to follow this guidance. So when you practice meditation, just think about that, right? How about my sattva and panya, my confidence and my wisdom? When sit meditate, you just think about, oh, this five aggregate, this six sense bases, or this indriya, some, just think, well, we have wisdom, more wisdom, just think about it. Stop. No concentration. See that? You have strong this confidence for it. Just try to practice, you don't know anything. It's not good. That's why sattva and panya, wisdom and sattva, you know, should be balanced. And virya and samadhi, some is just like practice walking meditation only. It's not good. Just sitting meditation only is not good. It should be balanced. Our posture after sitting should be walking, walking after walking should be sitting, should be balanced. Just virya and our concentration. And for the state, always necessary to be aware of any object, whatever occurs in our body, on our mind. Yeah. And bala. Bala is the main powers, right? Five powers. Sadda bala, virya bala, sati bala, samadhi bala, panya bala. What is different with indriya? Same, right? Same thing. Indriya and bala, right? Faculty and powers, the same. Their reality also the same. See that, right? Indriya and faculty and powers are identical. But here, especially here, indriya and bala has two distinct properties. Indriya faculty here has ability to control the mind. Right? Indriya, the ability to control the mind. Bala here, power here, has the ability to be firm. Have ability to be firm, and they cannot be overcome by opposing force. To gain enlightenment, not to be able to gain enlightenment, we need to sharpen our five faculties, Indriya. If our faculty is so weak, it's not sharp, we cannot gain enlightenment. So to be able to gain enlightenment, we need to sharpen the five mental faculties. We have 9 ways to sharpen. May some of you know that. 9 ways to sharpen the five mental faculties. Number one is aim to realize the impermanence of the physical process. Aim to realize the impermanence of the mental physical process. This is very important. When you practice meditation, maybe you contemplate on your body, your feeling, or your mind, or maybe the object, you know, just hindrances, or fight against, and so on. But your aim should be, you know, to realize impermanence. You should see the impermanence here all the time, every moment. You know, so, or for example, you contemplate on your feeling, your sensation. You see that pain. If you see pain, just wait now. It's not enough. What you have to see? The impermanence of this vedana, this vedana arising and this being arising, this being all the time, every moment. Yeah. You have to see that, your feeling, you know, this arising, this being all the time. Or even you practice walking meditation, maybe you step, you know, maybe you are lifting or pushing or dropping. Just see the movement. It's not enough for a meditator who practices inside Vipassana meditation. You have to notice the arising and disappearing of this physical mental process. Every moment, this means aim to realize impermanence of the mental physical process. It's very important. You should see. And then we call Vipassana insight meditation, otherwise just a tranquility meditation. Whatever here, you know, just sometime here or here out, you know, I guide our people to concentrate on our abdomen. You see, our abdomen rise and fall. If just see rise and fall, it's not enough. What do you have to see? Aim to realize impermanence. Rise, come and go away. Nothing, right? And falling, going, nothing. So every moment you see impermanence. See that, right? Impermanence. And see something pass in front of you, you see. Only just see, it's not enough. this tranquility meditation, that's in front of you, just the appears and disappears. See the awareness, the impermanence of whatever you see here, you hear, you smell, you taste, you touch, you think, just everything just impermanence, anicca, to see anicca. So aim to realize impermanence of the mental physical process is one kind of, you know, one way is to sharpen our faculties. We have 9 ways for today, just only one way we're talking about it. The remaining 8 will be discussing next week. But time's up, thank you. Any question today? Yes. Yeah.
But
isn't that
the other extreme?
Is it really? No, it's not extreme. This means when you practice, oh, this is my head, this is the body hair, this is my skin, this is my nail, this is my teeth, you know, this is my body, is the urine, this is the fistus, this is my lung, this is my kidney. See, inside, outside, just impurity, right? When you see impurity, disgusting, disgust, impurity, you will see, oh, my bodies are beautiful, you know, it's pretty. Yeah. If you think like that, it's that we call supa in Bali. So when you see asupa, impurity, you will discuss the beauty, the wrong. You see, oh, my body is very pretty, beautiful, even inside, outside, it's wrong you. When you see impurity in your body, this means you eradicate. Yeah. Yeah.
Isn't it something? It's still a label.
Yeah.
I mean, isn't it really just like no different than anything else? It's just neutral.
Body.
It's just body. It's just
cell. Yes, but someone they have the wrong view about their body. For example, you see, oh, my hair is very pretty, very beautiful, very nice, and then you attach to your hair, right? Then craving occurs. To be able to get rid of this craving, the Buddha taught us to contemplate on the 32 impure parts of the body. This is the main purpose of the Lord Buddha.